At this point, eye rolling is my teenage son's preferred method of communication with me. Dad. There's long been a tendency to, yes, roll your eyes whenever Donald Trump breaks a rule of politics. After all, this is a guy who suggested, with zero evidence, that Ted Cruz's father might have been involved in the assassination of John F. Kennedy, and who wrongly linked windmills to cancer, and who suggested using bleach and bright lights to combat COVID-19, which, of course, is total nonsense. So, look, Trump spent 4 years assaulting democracy and truth as president, and we're still mostly standing. I'm still standing. And Trump's not in office anymore, so what he does say on any given subject does take less import than it did 2 years ago. It's true. That attitude, I should note, is also totally understandable as a mental health coping tactic. Trump broke so many norms that worrying about any one of them is enough to drive you to distraction. The problem? That way of thinking is also deeply misguided. Let's go through a few facts. Fact one, Donald Trump remains the single most powerful figure in the Republican Party. Fact two, Donald Trump is the heavy favorite for the 2024 Republican presidential nomination if he decides to run, which he seems to want to do. Fact three, some polling suggests that if the election was held today, Trump would beat President Joe Biden. All of which brings me to something Trump said in an interview with the conservative TV show Just the News that was published late last month. He openly urged Russian President Vladimir Putin to publicly release any dirt he might have on Hunter Biden, the son of the current president of the United States.
I would think Putin would know the answer to that. I think he should release it. I think we should know that answer.
This, of course, isn't the first time that Trump has asked Russia for help in digging dirt on his political opponents. In July 2016, on the eve of the Democratic National Convention, Trump said this of emails sent by Hillary Clinton during her time as Secretary of State.
Russia, if you're listening, I hope you're able to find the 30,000 emails that are missing. I think you will probably be rewarded mightily by our press.
Sidebar, around that same time, an indictment from the Department of Justice stated that Russian intelligence operatives attempted to gain access to Clinton's email accounts. And let's also not forget this. We know Russia actively meddled in the 2016 election to help Trump and hurt Clinton. Now, imagine for just a minute if any other politician did anything remotely like this, asking on more than one occasion for a foreign adversary to help find damaging information about a political opponent. Such a request by a Democrat about a Republican president would bring cascades of condemnations, with some within the GOP likely suggesting that the request was unpatriotic, right? Right, right. But Trump has so moved the goalposts of acceptable conduct as it relates to what he says and does, that the chances of his appeal to Russia to find dirt on Hunter Biden will barely make a ripple in the political pool. Plunk. In fact, North Dakota Senator Kevin Cramer, a Republican, seemed to echo Trump's appeal to Russia. Quote, I don't know if he has dirt on Biden, Cramer told CNN. If he does, he should reveal it. But he is a war criminal, so I don't expect that he's right now sitting around thinking about ways that he can reveal other information, end quote. This is both wrong and dangerous. Trump's 4 years in office, culminating with the U.S. Capitol riot on January 6, 2021, revealed that simply rolling your eyes, or as so many Republicans have done and continue to do, sticking your head in the sand, there's sand down there, has real-world consequences. Those consequences? An emboldened Trump who continues to lean into ideas like the election was stolen and that a cover-up of Biden wrongdoing is ongoing. And unfortunately, lots and lots of people who believe what Trump says, no matter what the facts say. Those consequences mean that you can't just say, that's just Trump being Trump. Because Trump being Trump has gotten us to where we are right now, which is a very dangerous place. And that is the point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. I hope you check them all out.